It is so exciting. Google has updated the Chrome browser to version 69, and it is a material design. What does that mean? I'll show you today on DOTTO-Tech. Steve Dotto here. How the heck you doing this fine day? At DOTTO-Tech, we make technology easy so you can do more. Now, today we're going to be taking a look at the new refreshed version of Google Chrome, which Google released in the 10th anniversary of the launch of their now legendary web browser, Google Chrome. And they've now incorporated something called material design into their overall design of Chrome. I don't know about you, but I had no idea of what material design is. It's probably something I should know, but I admit I didn't know. So I Google searched it, and this is what I came up with. Sit back and relax and learn about material design on DOTTO-Tech. Material design is a visual language that synthesizes the classic principles of good design with the innovation of technology and science. Do you feel better informed now? No, neither do I. Let's scroll down and take a look. The goals of it are to create a visual language that synthesizes the classic principles of good design with the innovation and possibility of technology and science. Nope. Unify, developing a single underlying system that unifies the user experience across platforms, devices, and input methods. That makes a little bit of sense to me. Okay, so a common interface that works on all of our devices, all of our operating systems. Okay, I understand now a little bit of what material design is. Reading through it, if you want to know more, they just want to create more of a real world physical metaphor to a certain extent. I'm not explaining it well. Here's what we see when we see material design in the browser. Here's our new version of the browser. It looks pretty much the same, doesn't it? But what's different here is along the top. Now they have little vertical lines instead of angled lines separating our tabs. That's pretty much it. I know I'm going to get vilified by the design community, but I think it's pretty much a tempest in a pot of tea. What is new is they've actually developed some new and created and released some new underlying technology in the Chrome browser, which to me is far more exciting than verticalizing my tabs. Here's what they've added. Oh, before I go on, if you don't know if you have the new version or if your Chrome has not updated, just go under the About Chrome menu. And there in About Chrome, it will check for updates and it will allow you to relaunch Chrome with the latest version if you don't have the latest build already installed. That is the easiest way to get to the new version. Now, here there's two areas that Google has, I think, significantly improved what Chrome does. The first is in the Aamna Bar. The Aamna Bar is what we used to call the address bar. Now they have made it all curvy now, which is nice, but a while ago, they started to change how we interface with the address bar in the Chrome browser, and they renamed it the Aamna Bar, which allowed us to, as we type information in, it give us instant access to what we're looking for rather than having to go to a web page. So if, for example, I'm a football fan and I want to see what the Seattle Seahawks score is in their football game, I type in Seattle Seahawks, and as I type in the name, it comes up with the score of the last game. So I can be disappointed instantly without having to go to a page to look at the scores. There it is. So I see the last. Now, if I want to see what the weather's like in Seattle this week, instead of searching in and going to a weather site, as I start to type in the word weather, it gives me the current weather conditions. So it's trying to anticipate what we're looking for and fill in that information. And it's pretty robust in what it does. I think if you pay attention to what's happening in the Aamna Bar as you type in search queries or type in different things in, you'll probably be pleasantly surprised with how much information is portrayed and how much it saves you time. For example, what day is Easter? And there it is. It comes up. It's Sunday, April 21st in 2019. That's what, if people want to know what day is Easter, if they're worried about that. What's the exchange rate? I'm in Canada, and I want to go US dollar exchange rate. And there it comes up with one Canadian dollar, knows I'm in Canada, is 77 US cents. There we go. I know, and I can be depressed instantly looking at how the Canadian dollar is doing against the US counterpart. So the Aamna Bar gives us instant access to a lot more information. Pay attention to what's happening there. I think you'd be pleasantly surprised. The other big change that they've added is, again, subtle, but built into the autofill and password area, which if you haven't checked out, you should probably take a look at. Go into your settings in Chrome, and there you've got payment methods and addresses, as well as passwords, all clustered right here at the top. So the first change is in the password area. Chrome will save passwords for you. It always has saved web passwords for you. But now it will suggest cryptic passwords, much like the way we do in LastPass or 1Password or some of the other more advanced password managers. It still doesn't have the sharing features and some of the other things that those tools have, but it now will suggest far better and more cryptic passwords for you to use if as you're creating new accounts on sites. That's a good idea for them to have added. While you're on it, even though they haven't changed this, you should check out what's happening in the payment methods in the addresses area, because this is something that's just a good idea to refresh as far as your relationship with your Chrome browser. At various times when you've purchased things in the past, Chrome has said, would you like me to save your credit card information or your address? And it saves that so that you can autofill forms in the future to speed things up. So make sure that you're comfortable with the information that's being saved in these. That's all I'm saying, is go in and make sure that the address is accurate as far as your autofill, and that you're happy to have your credit cards stored in the payment system if you do have a credit card stored with them, and make sure that it's the correct number and everything is up to date. And if you're uncomfortable having your credit card stored in Chrome, well, go ahead and delete it from Chrome and then enter it manually the next time. It's up to you to take responsibility for your personal privacy. Chrome's going to try and give you some nice benefits of flexibility and convenience by storing it for you, but you might not be comfortable with that. Your decision. All in all, I think that the actual material design part of this might be a little bit of a tempest in a pot of tea, but some of the additional functionality of the new Chrome browser, I kind of like. I think that they've done a good job in adding to our browsing experience with the new version of Chrome. I love reading your comments and suggestions, so please post below. I do read every single one. If you like this video, please give it a like and share it with your friends or colleagues who may find it useful. Now make sure you've subscribed and hit that notification bell. And if you have time, check out some of our other videos right over there. Till next time, I'm Steve Dotto. Have fun storming a castle.